Dear students, this is VTU e-Sikshana program 18 MAT DIP 41, the subject code, and the subject title is Additional Mathematics 2nd. In that, I am Dr. Basavarajappa speaking about the first module, that is Linear Algebra, for lecture series, that is lecture number 1. In this Linear Algebra, let me mention what are the topics of that. Later I shall give the introduction of this matrix and the determinant, and what is the difference of matrix and determinant, and later we shall solve according to the syllabus, the contents of the syllabus, one by one. We will discuss the theoretical part and as well as the problems in that particular topic. The contents, main contents of this module are like this. The main title is Linear Algebra. In this Linear Algebra, we have the following contents. The first one, rank of the matrix. And the second one, by elementary row operations. Elementary row operations. Next is echelon form. Next is consistency. Next is Gauss elimination method. Gauss elimination method, eigenvalues, and eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a square matrix, and finally problems on all these topics. Here we discuss the introduction of matrix, that is first topic, rank of the matrix by elementary row operations. Next is echelon form, we call it as row echelon form, and the consistency of system of linear equations, Gauss elimination method, eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a square matrix. Then all these contents will be followed with the respective problems. So first let us discuss what is the meaning of matrix and why this matrix topic is required in engineering course, and what is the main goal of studying the determinants and then matrix, where it will come as important application in various engineering problems. Now, matrix is, in this linear algebra, we are taking this only the matrix. Then matrix is an arrangement of array of numbers in the form of rows and columns. For example, you have some system of equations, that is two equations with two unknowns. Then easily we can solve those two equations with two unknowns by making one of the coefficients same, and then we can cancel one coefficient and another coefficient we can calculate. Okay. Similarly, when you have three equations with three unknowns, then you need to write by some procedure the values of the unknowns you have to calculate. Suppose you have four equations with four unknowns. Likewise, five equations with the five unknowns. And more than that, five, like that. So it is not easy to solve by the basic methods for solving and getting the values of the unknowns in the system of linear equations, where we discuss these things by arranging the coefficients of the given unknowns in rows and columns, and then we can calculate the corresponding procedure of applying row operations for these given numbers which are arranged in the form of rows and columns, and then we can find out the values of the unknowns. Okay, so first is rank of the matrix and all that. First of all, what is matrix, what are the types of matrices, and what are the limitations of matrices, and then we can go for rank of the matrix by row operations. Okay, right from the lower level classes you have been studying about the matrices, the meaning of matrices, and then I expect all of you to recall what the basic concepts in matrices you have studied so far, and you have to recall all those things, then you can apply that knowledge for utilizing the matrices as row operations, matrices as consistency, matrices as Gauss elimination method, and in that matrix what are special values, we call them as eigenvalues or characteristic values or latent values, and what are the vectors which are written in that form, we call them as eigenvectors and eigenvalues of the square matrix. Okay, let me write some important definitions in this matrices, just to give a revision or recapitulation about the basics of matrices, and then I shall go one by one of these topics. The definition of this matrix is, it is an array of numbers arranged as rows and columns and it is not a numerical value. Whereas determinant will be taken as it's a numerical value. It can be simplified, whereas matrix cannot be simplified. Suppose you apply determinant to the matrix, then it can be simplified. Okay, following are the notations used to represent the matrix. One is like square bracket, and next one is thick open brackets, and next one is double bar. This is first, this is second, and this is third. So any one of these three notations we will use, but more generally we will use the first one, which is of just like a square brackets type. That is called matrix, and only with single bar on both sides, just like modulus symbol, that represents determinant. If you write double bar on each side, then it is called matrix. So any one of these three notations we are going to use. Okay, then suppose we have three linear equations with three unknowns, as a11x plus a12y plus a13z is equal to v1. Next is a21x plus a22y plus a23z that is equal to b2. Next is a31x plus a32y plus a33z equal to b3. If these three equations are given to us, that means first equation contains x, y, z as unknowns, and the last one is b1, and second equation contains x, y, z as unknowns, and last right side symbol is b2, and next is x, y, z as unknowns, and b3 is the constant on the right side. Now, when we have these three equations, then we can put in the form of matrix symbol, then that matrix symbol has to be utilized for various types of definitions and various types of operations on matrices. That means various types of matrices on operations means that is nothing but addition, multiplication, subtraction, even row operation for any purpose. For any purpose, we will use the corresponding representation of the matrix for these three equations. All the coefficients are constants, but only the variables or unknowns we can say. In those unknowns, we can write that is x, y, z. But right side values b1, b2, b3 are constants. Then, first of all, let us use these three equations to be written in a matrix form. That matrix notation, the first one I will take in the form of square brackets. Denoting as matrix form of these three equations, we write like this: a11, a12, a13, a21, a22, a23, a31, a32, a33. And it is multiplied by the unknowns x, y, z, and this is b1, should be b2 and b3. This is the matrix representation. This implies A x is equal to b. This is called matrix equation. This is called matrix equation, where A equal to, this is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, and A31, A32, A33 is called coefficient matrix. This is called the coefficient matrix. And the next, X, capital X is equal to column matrix X, Y, Z. This is matrix of unknowns. Matrix of unknowns. And another one, last one, that is capital V is equal to, that is also column matrix B1, B2 and B3. So this is matrix of constants. No doubt these are also constants, but we call them as coefficients of the three unknowns X, Y and Z. Okay, so this is the matrix equation, and this is representing three equations, but in one form matrix equation we can write, that is capital A into X is equal to B. A is called coefficient matrix, X is called matrix of unknowns, and B is called column matrix with the constants which are given as values on the right side. Okay, so when once we have this type of representation, and some more definitions we will define depending on this basic representation. So I will call this as 2 and the equations without matrix symbol, that I will represent it as equation 1 and this equation as equation 2. Okay. Afterwards, the next definition will be square matrix. The matrix A equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. This is nothing but 3 cross 3 is equal to M cross N is equal to rows into columns. That means number of rows into columns. That means M number of rows and N number of columns. That means M number of rows and N number of columns means we have rows and columns as M is equal to 3 and N is equal to 3. If M equal to N implies A, that means matrix A, is called square matrix. Matrix A is called square matrix. If M is not equal to N, matrix A is called non-square matrix. Non-square matrix. Example: A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23. A31, A32, A33, A14, A24, A34. If it is like this, for example, here you can say that M cross N is equal to, that means number of rows, M is number of rows, that is M here, number of rows are 3 and M cross N number of columns are 4. That means M is not equal to N. This is called one sample, that is called non-square matrix. And another case where you can take an example and example A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A32, A31, A33, A41, A42, A43. If this is the matrix, this is equal to A, implies this is M cross N is equal to, that is 4 rows into 3 columns. Here 3 rows, 4 columns, but here 4 rows and 3 columns. That means when M is not equal to N, we'll say that is called a non-square matrix. Next definition is unit matrix. The matrix A equal to 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 is called unit matrix is called unit matrix. Next, diagonal matrix. What is the diagonal matrix? Diagonal matrix is the matrix. In place of 1, 1, we have other than 1. Not necessarily all the three numbers should be equal to 1. And above the principal diagonal. This is called the principal diagonal. Otherwise, main diagonal. So, above and below the numbers should be 0. And diagonal elements must be 1, 1, 1. Then it is called as unit matrix. If those values are not 1, 1, 1, then we call it as diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix means the matrix A equal to, like this I write, 0, 0, 0, A 2, 2, 0, 0, A 3, 3, is called diagonal matrix. Is called diagonal matrix. In that diagonal, A 1 1 is equal to A 2 2 equal to A 3 3 not equal to 1. All the three should not be equal to 1. If all the three are equal to 1, we call it as unit matrix. Next, upper triangular matrix. In this upper triangular matrix, we expect from the represented equations as a matrix form in the coefficient matrix, if all the elements above the principal diagonal are non-zero and the elements below the principal diagonal are converted as zero, then it is called upper triangular matrix. And another one is lower triangular matrix. It is the opposite meaning of this upper triangular matrix. Now, the matrix A equal to A 1 1 and A 1 2, A 1 3, 0, A 2 2, A 2 3 and 0 0 A 3 3. This is principal diagonal and this is the case of all the three numbers must be 0 in the case of square matrix. So that is called square matrix where number of rows are the same as number of columns. It is called the square matrix. Okay. Then here is called upper triangular matrix. Then another opposite form is lower triangular matrix. Lower triangular matrix. The matrix A equal to, that is A 1 1 0 0, A 2 1 A 2 2 0, A 3 1 A 3 2 A 3 3. This is the principal diagonal. Is called lower triangular matrix. That means elements above the principal diagonal are converted to 0. Then elements below the principal diagonal, all the three must not be 0. Anyone among those three may be 0. It is by coincidence in the calculation, right? but all the three should not be equal to 0. Then we call it as lower triangular matrix. This is upper triangular means elements below the principal diagonal must be 0 and elements above the principal diagonal must be 0 in the next case. That is called upper triangular as well as lower triangular matrix. Okay. So next is null matrix. Next definition, null matrix. What is the meaning of null matrix? If all the elements inside the matrix symbol are given as 0 or are converted to 0, then it is called as null matrix. Okay. The matrix A equal to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 is called null matrix. These are few definitions where we can apply the values for any of the required calculation. Maybe it is for row operations, maybe it is for eigenvalues, maybe it is for calculation of the consistency and all that. But whenever you call the single row and single column respectively, they are called as row matrix and column matrix. Okay. So next we study what is the rank of the matrix. That is the next question as per your syllabus. Rank of the matrix. It is the order of the matrix. It is the order of the matrix in which the elementary row operation is applied such that rank is equal to number of non-zero rows, when you count after applying the row operation. Now we have to understand what is the meaning of row operation. That is the next definition. Elementary row operation. Now, as per your syllabus, you have to expect the problems from this topic onwards. First of all, you have to understand what is the meaning of elementary row operation. Elementary row operation is nothing but how many rows we are getting in the matrix. Either it is formed from the number of equations given, system of linear equations, or matrix itself is given, then we need to operate the first row on the remaining, the second row on the remaining, and the third row on the remaining. Likewise, it will be continued with the help of the leading element we call the first element of every row, but at different stages it changes. Then it should be non-zero element, and we call it as pivotal element, or we call it as leading element. We will use that element to be operated on the respective column, and then we have to make those numbers as 0. Then finally, how many times we have to operate the first row, second row, third row, and how many stages we have to carry out, it all depends on how many rows are given. For example, 3 rows are given, then you need to operate first row on second and third, and second row on third row to make the respective column element as 0. that is called elementary row operation. When once row operation is completed, then you have to count how many non-zero rows are left at the end when elementary row operation is completed. Okay, that is equal to the rank of the matrix. So rank of A is equal to, it is the order, otherwise number of rows, number of non-zero rows left after the row operation procedure is applied to the given matrix. So that is what the procedure. Now elementary row operation takes the meaning, but how to operate? Operation means you have to first select two rows. For example, three rows are there, R1, R2, R3. Then you need to multiply to one of the two rows by a non-zero number and simply add it to the remaining to make the forthcoming element as zero. This is called the basic requirement of elementary row operation. I repeat this. You have to choose two rows, for example R1 and R2. You have to multiply one of the two rows by some non-zero number and simply add it to the remaining to get the forthcoming element as zero. So that is the first step of elementary row operation. In the next step, when once first row operation chance is over, then you have to ignore that and you have to start with second row leading element, that is called pivotal element, and then you have to operate that second row leading element on the remaining rows. Then how to operate that, I shall give in the example, but I shall write now the definition. After that, one sample of example I will take, and then I will let you know how to follow that procedure as elementary row operation calculation. Now, what is the definition? Then here, multiply by a non-zero number to one of the two rows and add it to the remaining rows to convert the respective column element as zero. The respective column element as zero. This is the procedure for elementary row operation. Here, so rank, according to your syllabus, rank is to be calculated using elementary row operation. But there is also another method which is not in your syllabus. When you take the determinant of the square matrix, then also you can define the rank of the matrix. When you apply the determinant, what is the order given for m cross n, then when you apply the determinant to the given matrix, if that determinant value is not equal to 0, then the rank is equal to the order of that particular matrix. If that is equal to 0, then you have to choose the next lower order, that is called minor. Then if it is given as 3 cross 3, then you have to choose any possible 2 cross 2 and see that all the 2 cross 2 possible matrices should be applied with the determinant, and then you have to make it as, you have to verify for 0. If all of them are 0, then rank is not 3, rank is not 2. Okay, but anyway, that procedure is not there in your syllabus. Only I can speak and we can discuss only about elementary row operation method to find out the rank of the matrix. So now I think I can take one example how this elementary row operation method is going to be applied. Through example, I think this procedure you can understand very quickly. Now I should take the first example on how to find out the rank of the matrix. Then afterwards, the remaining examples you can consider. Okay. Then I should take one example using this procedure. Example, find the rank of the matrix A equal to, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 5, 8 and 22. 5, 8, 22. So this is what kind of matrix it is? It is square matrix, because number of rows are 3 and number of columns are also 3. That means number of rows is equal to number of columns, that is 3 equal to 3, then you can say that it is called square matrix.
Okay. So in the solution, find the rank of the matrix by row operations.
By the elementary row operations procedure. Okay.
So now let A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7 and 5, 8 and 22. There are 3 rows here and 3 columns. That means this is 3 cross 3 and rank is to be taken multiplying by non-zero number, elementary row operations only to square matrix.
Now, afterwards we will think for non-square matrix. Even non-square matrix also we can discuss. Now I am giving the problem with only the square matrix.
Then, this is for R1, we call row 1, and this is for row 2, and this is for row 3. You name this. Then you apply this definition.
Multiply. First you have to choose any two rows.
Now, the leading element is, this is called pivotal element, otherwise pivotal elemental, right? For your understanding, this is PE. PE means pivotal element. Pivotal element. What is that pivotal element? It is called leading element. Pivotal element, or it is called leading element. Okay. Now you have to choose two rows. In those two rows, then you have to operate between those two. Now using this one, you have to operate on this remaining. You have to convert these two elements as zero. So whatever parallelly the effect is going to be utilized on the remaining elements like 4, 6, 7, then 5, 8, 22 in the third column, second and third column. The same effect we are going to write in the next forthcoming step.
Okay.
Then, with the help of this, we have to make these two elements of zero using this definition. That means multiply by a non-zero number to one of the two rows and add it to the remaining. That means two rows at a time you cannot multiply. You cannot multiply by non-zero number. That means one row you have to keep constant and another row you have to take for multiplication. Okay. So in that way, if you apply this procedure, we have two rows R1, R2, then pair R1 and R3. From the first pair of rows, that is R1 and R2, you have to make these two elements, you have to take these two elements for your reference, and then you have to operate between these two and you have to make it as 0. Okay. So this is a smaller number I will take, minus 2 times R1 plus R2, effecting on R2. Hope you will understand this procedure according to the definition. Next, minus 3 R1 plus R3, and effecting on it is R3. That means here you can say that minus 2 R1 plus R2 effecting on R2, minus 3 R1 plus R3. That means second position I kept constant. It is not a rule. We can disturb the second position and keep the first position constant like that. Otherwise, disturbing first position and keeping second position. That is what the meaning here. Multiply by a non-zero number to one of the two rows. Non-zero number means minus 2. But another row number I kept it as constant. That means here minus 2 into plus 1 that is plus of 2 is equal to minus 2 plus 2, this is equal to 0.
Our main goal is to make that particular element in that respective column as 0. So this is what you are getting, this number as 0. And this number here, this is 3 is there, 3 is there, but here second position I am giving constant, that is plus 3. But if you are getting minus 3 in the first position, then simplification gives us 0.
Therefore, we can convert this one as minus 3 R1 plus R3 tends to, that is R3.
Okay.
Then what you have to do? This must be this must be made as 0. Therefore, minus 3 into 1, that is equal to minus 3 plus 3. The answer is, it is equal to 0.
That means we are multiplying to the previous row and we are keeping next row as undisturbed. Okay, in the similar fashion, the first row on the second, first row on the third.
So with this operation, now you have to write what is the effect on the remaining elements in the elementary row operation procedure. Then A is equivalent to, this symbol we use, A is equivalent to, with the effect of these numbers. Okay, first row is undisturbed, that is 1, 4, 5, because this is called leading row, otherwise pivotal row, but the first element is called pivotal element, it must be always non-zero number, it should not be 0. If it is 0, then interchange any two rows or any two columns, because that condition is allowed in matrices, then you can interchange any two rows and any two columns in order to make number 0 as non-zero number, which is expected as pivotal element. Then this is 1, 4, 5, and we made this effect as 0 in the first one. Now you apply this procedure between these two numbers. Minus 2 or 1 means minus 4. Minus 2 into 4, minus 2 into 4 plus 6 equal to minus 8 and plus of 6. What is the value? This is equal to 2. Next, minus 2 R1, R1 means 5. So minus 2 into 5 plus second position, that is plus 8, that is 10, and plus of 8. Minus 10 plus 8 means it is minus 2. Here also you are getting minus 2. Next, that is over. First row on the remaining, second row is over. Now first row on the third row. This should be minus 3 or 1. Minus 3 into 1. Anyway, this is 0. This is 0. Already we made this one as 0. Minus 3 into 4. Minus 3 into 4 plus 7. This is equal to minus 12 plus 7. This is minus 5. This is one number. And next, minus 5 is there, but minus 3 you have to multiply. Minus 3 into 5. And the next number is 22. That is 22 is equal to, that is minus 3 into 5 means minus 15 and plus 22. This is equal to plus 7. Okay. And this is minus 12 plus 7 means, that is minus 5, minus 15 plus 22 means it is 7. Okay, so this is
one's operation. That means you have to come from top to bottom, R1 on R2 and R3, and next is R2 on R3. This is called elementary row operation. Top to bottom you have to come. Even column operation also people do that, but anyone you learn, both are okay. Both, if you have learnt already column operation, then you can continue. Otherwise, row operation is normally convenient for all the forthcoming topics also. So that I am following row operations, I am just explaining. But both are okay. That is also equally good.
Now, this is to be taken for the next chance. Operate second row on the third row. One more chance is there. Then your leading element, that means pivotal element, is 2. This is called PE. Then you have to make this element as 0. using the same procedure, whatever here you used,
that means multiply by non-zero number to one of the two rows. One of the two rows means what? Here we have second row and third row. Okay, and previous position you have to keep multiplying, and for next position you have to keep constant.
Okay, so let me apply in that way. What is this procedure in the next column that we have to write? So here by minus 2, in the same fashion, here 5 is there, minus 5 is there, you must get plus 5. And this 2 we don't want, 2 is to be cancelled, plus 5. That means minus of 5 divided by 2, if you multiply 2, R2, and plus R3, effecting on R3. This element you have to convert as 0. Since minus 5 is already there, in the previous position, if you are getting plus 5, then with that plus 5 and adding to this minus 5, you will be getting the answer as 0. Therefore, plus 5 and minus 5 is equal to 0. Thereby, you will be getting the next chance here. This should be 145. Second row should be constant. That is 0, it is minus 2, and it is minus 2, and next is 0, and this is converted as 0, and with this operation, that is minus 5 by 2 into R2, R2 means minus 2, okay. Here, this element, minus 2 into minus 5 by 2 plus R3 plus 7. It is 7 is there, you know. Okay. Then this 2 cancels. This is equal to plus 5 minus into minus plus 5 and plus 7. This is 12. This is the number 12. Okay. Now R1 on R2 and R3 is over. And R2 on R3 is over. This is called elementary row operation method. Now you have to conclude your answer by writing what is the rank of the matrix is equal to number of non-zero rows left after the elementary operation row operation method is over. Now elementary row operation method is over already, because R1 there are 3 rows. We have first row on the remaining, second row on the remaining, third row on the remaining means no rows. Therefore, that is the end of the procedure. This is for 3 rows and 3 columns. Therefore, at the end of the procedure, this is the leading diagonal. Okay. Then, the rank of the matrix you have to declare like this. Therefore, the rank of the matrix is equal to number of non-zero rows, number of non-zero rows means 0 row is 1 where all the elements in that particular row are 0. Otherwise, if at least one number is not 0, then we call it as non-zero row. Therefore, this is not 0, therefore this is non-zero row, and obviously other two rows are non-zero rows. Therefore, that is equal to 3. Here, this one we represent R of A is equal to 3. This is represented as rank of the matrix, that is R of A is equal to 3. That is nothing but number of rows which are non-zero at the end of applying the procedure of elementary row operation, you are getting it as the count you have to take number of non-zero rows. Similarly, another example I shall take in order to find out the rank of the matrix. Next example will be finding the rank of the matrix A equal to 1, 1, 2, 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, 3, 2, 5.
This is the same type of problem as we discussed in the first problem. 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay. Let me solve this problem using elementary row operation procedure. Solution. Let the given matrix, we shall take the given matrix as it is. That is 1, 1, 2, and next is 2, 4, 6, and next column that is 3, 2, and then 5. 3, 2, and 5. Okay. Now this is named as R1, this is named as R2. This is named as R3. Then, this is our pivotal element. Anyway, it is non-zero. And these two elements, you have to make them as zero using elementary row operation technique. Then, we have to make these two elements as zero means minus R1 plus R2 affecting on R2 and minus 2 times R1 plus R3 affecting on R3. So this is what I am taking. R, another procedure. If you want to keep the first position as constant, that is R1 minus R2 affecting on R2. R1 minus 1 by 2, because 1 is there, you must get minus 1 and 2 you have to remove, that is R3. And affecting on R3. Any one of these two procedures you can take in order to apply the elementary row operation method and to make the corresponding column elements as zero. Therefore, these two column elements you must convert them as zero and with the help of elementary row operation technique. Then A is equal to that much. So the one is the pivotal element. This is called PE and next is column elements as 0. With this procedure, either this type you can take or this type multiplication by the non-zero numbers you can take. Both are allowed, but any one you have to use. Okay. Then A is equivalent to, this is 1, 2, 3, we are not disturbing first row, and this is made as 0, and this one according to this minus R1 plus R2, minus 2 plus 4, that is plus 2, minus 3 plus 2, it is minus 1, and minus 2 times R1, this is 0, minus 2 times means minus 4, that is plus 2, and minus 2 times R1, that is 6, minus 6, and plus 5, minus 6 plus 5 means it is minus 1. Then this is first row, this is second row R2, and this is third row. After applying elementary row operation for one step, still one more step you have to apply. What is that one more step? Still, if this becomes the pivotal element, so this becomes the pivotal element, and this is the number that you have to make it as 0. Therefore, the number which is second element in the third row is to be converted as 0 using this procedure. Because I have followed this, I did not follow this one. According to this previous row, I had to disturb. Okay, previous row means this is pivotal element, E. Then, here 2 is there, 2 is there. You have to get between these two mathematical operation, if you use, you must get it as 0. What symbol you are going to use? Subtraction. Subtraction from the first to second. Okay. This must be minus of R2 plus R3 affecting on R3. Therefore, between these two elements, when you add by multiplying by non-zero number that is called minus 1,
you will be getting this value as 0. Therefore, A is equivalent to 1, 2, 3, 0, and this is 2, and minus 1, and 0, and this is 0, and this is minus, this is also 0 coincidentally. I think this is some interesting problem. Now, this chance of using first row on second and third is over, and the chance of using second row on third row, that is also over, and chance of using third row on the remaining is no row exists. Therefore, it is the end of the procedure. Operate R1 on R2 and R3, operate R2 on R3, and then find the corresponding column elements and make the corresponding column elements as 0. Therefore, A is equivalent to 1, 2, 3. Therefore, this complete row is called 0 row. This is called 0 row. Therefore, rank of A, matrix A, is equal to R of A is equal to number of non-zero rows. Non-zero rows, how many? That is equal to 2. Here, third row is completely 0. This is called 0 row. So, non-zero rows means 2 is not 0, minus 1 is not 0, 1 is not 0, 2 is not 0, 3 is not 0. Therefore, all these elements are not 0. First row and second row are called non-zero rows. Therefore, R of A is equal to, in this case, it is 2, but in the previous case, it is equal to 3. Because third element in the previous problem, third element of the third row was non-zero. But in this case, all the three elements have become 0. That means, here, rank of the matrix, what we understood within 3 cross 3, in the next lecture, I'll be giving, that is, a 4 cross 4 even non-square matrix also, what is the rank, let me explain in the next class.